Last Saturday, Nigerians woke up to the news of the death of a former senator representing Ogun East, Buruji Kashamu, after suffering from COVID-19 complications. Senator Murray Bruce announced the senator's death in a tweet. Kashamu was born Eshoji Nodu in Ogun State, Nigeria, on 19th of May 1958. He started his primary education at Asarodun Primary School, Ijebu Igbo, and left in 1972 to complete his primary school education at St. John Modern School, Lagos. Kashamu then attended evening classes at Igbobi College while working as a license agent. Later went to London, where he took courses in business management at the Pitman College, London. Kashamu was awarded a honorary PhD by the unaccredited diploma Mill Cambridge Graduate University, located in Master Suites at a privately organized ceremony in Lagos, Nigeria. He was a chieftain of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, in Ogun State. He contested for the Ogun State East senatorial seat and defeated his closest rival with a poll of 99,540 votes. The politician was appointed as the chairman, Organization and Mobilization Committee of the PDP in the southwest zone of Nigeria. In 2018, he was expelled from the People's Democratic Party, a decision later voided by an Abuja High Court in October 2018. He was the flag bearer of the People's Democratic Party in the 2019 Ogun State gubernatorial election and lost against the present governor of Ogun State, Dapo Abiodun, of the All Progressive Congress, APC. In 1998, Kashamu was arrested in the United Kingdom on drugs-related charges after trying to enter the country with $230,000 in cash. He was acquitted and released in 2003. In this his last interview, he talked about his politics, People Democratic Party, his fight with his opponent in Ogun State politics, Ladi Adebutu, and the future he never saw.
He got to that position. Before his arrival, before he became the party chairman, Akibel Dayo was an hunter, was zero. He came with only one house, which he did not even finish at that time. But he left with about almost 6 houses. When it remained 6 months, when it remained 1 month for him to leave that position, he decided to sell the structure to Bagadimutu and betray everyone of us. And that is why you have been saying a lot of misunderstanding, a lot of battle. We have been exchanging many words between each other. Even if I'm going to say something from now to tomorrow, it's not going to change anything. Only the action. And the fact that the matter is now in court, your son, which the other ESCO and the other members have engaged in, we have to leave that matter in the hands of. But you, left for you to draw the truth from all the communication, all what we have been saying, with all what we have been published, which we have been publishing, which you are well aware, for you to be able to determine or to know the truth, which you can continue to be telling the public. If I have to continue to be dragging, it's not going to change anything. I've decided to leave this area in the hands of competent court to decide when the matter comes.
And there are finance. After all this, because some of us know how passionate you are about the development of your party, PDP, and the success of your party, do you have plans of strengthening the party and make the party the party of choice in your state?
Thank you very much. That is what we have started. When we lost election, to stay behind, to put my things in order, because I lost a lot of money. That for a good 4 years, I've been fighting to put the party together. Some people are in the other side trying to scatter the party. I mean that is like they are able to. But at the end of the day, during the election, you can see I was at the law side, while he was at the legality side, together with the national. When the law says this, if it say contrary to the law, we have to fight the last minute when the INEC decided who's to be the candidate or not. But believe me, I have to say something here. If it wasn't because of like the Adebutu arrogance, there's no need we will not be in the government today. There's no need we will not be in the government of Ogun State today. But because of his arrogance and he believe that he has arrived, he believe that he can betray anybody the way Engineer Bayo betrayed. When Engineer Bayo betrayed me, if that they are able to can take Engineer Bayo to betray me, he should be able to know that Engineer Bayo can be the same. But so far the two of them are always the same. You understand what I'm saying? Because if you remember, our group, we were the one that gave that Adebutu to ticket to become House of Rep, to become honorable House of Rep, which of course he won with all the support we give to him. It wasn't up to 3 months that he got there, then he decided to give U-turn and started fighting with the structure up to today because he wanted to become a governor. Has never called me one day to tell me that he wants to become a governor, for me to say maybe I don't want to follow him or I don't want to support him. But if you don't tell me that you want to become a governor and you believe that yes, because your father is us, my own best friend that you met with me, Pharisee, is now supporting you, your son. So it's for you to betray me and Pharisee, you see, in order to destroy the foundation of the structure that I built in Southwest. Then you believe that you can betray me and put my back on the floor. Then I refuse. And that is why the problem continues up to today. So now, after losing the election, there's no reason for all to lose that election if it is not because of the continuation of his betrayal. We're in court. We both agree that let us work together. Anybody that wins the case, we take over later. 2 days before the election, if you remember, they delivered the judgment in Abeokuta. Then he packed all his own supporters to APA to go and sign agreement with APA. That is where they footed. So he took almost 50% of our supporters to the other side. Then he left maybe about 50 or 60%, you know what I'm saying, which I control. So if he joined the APA, and at the end of the day, they cannot even be able to win election at that time, why does he have to continue with this problem again? What makes him to think that even though if he succeeds in getting the structure from me, from us, that he will be able to win the election? When you fail to win the election, when you join with APN the other time, that APC stay, your son defeated us, and what makes him to think that yes, even though if you take the structure, you push the family away, that you will be able, you understand what I'm saying? So because of all this after the first election, I moved back to go and set up because I lost a lot of things through my business. So I stay quiet. Let me rest for 1 year, 1.5 years, and then from there we can start putting things together. But by doing that, they believe that maybe I am weak. Maybe I don't know what your son, and from there they started writing all this rubbish, saying all this kind of rubbish, and eventually Engineer Bell decided to betray. Then, well, of course, if it's like that, something that I was thinking of maybe thinking of doing in the next, maybe by next year, January, to start putting things together. Then, if it is like that, so far, they want to kill this party now. It's not better for me to intervene immediately and to start putting things in order. So that is why I decided to do so. And since 2 months, 3 months, I've started putting all our members that have gone to APC, all of them have started coming back, and we started reinforcing the structure, which I believe that eventually, very soon, all the people, all the members that went to Lavi, who are not satisfied over there, who as some of them, a lot of them has moved from there to APC, we are trying to bring them back, we have been bringing many of them back, and we believe that those who are with Lavi, 80% of them, they are tired. Okay, now all of them, many of them have been calling that he doesn't know politics. They don't understand the way he does his politics. So many of them, and the fact that we even declare that, no, it's okay, Lavi, you are Nigerian brother. We are not running away. You are the one. Me, I don't want to become governor. I don't want to contest for governorship again. I don't want to contest for Senate again. Lavi, you are the one who is looking for governorship. You are the member, one of the leaders of the party. Let us join hands together to reconcile everybody so that we can be stronger to face opponents. But I don't know. He wants to be an Alpha Omega. He wants to be an Alpha Omega. He doesn't want any other person that is going to outshine him. Because what does he know? If it's not the money of his father, has he ever worked before? Do you understand that thing? So if me, as a leader, facing Enugu State, he is a leader, he knows that my own life is very simple, that people love me. He knows that people will always prefer me more than him. But he wants to be Alpha Omega. So that is why he can never, and he's using that structure to make money from his father. That is why he can never allow the settlement of PDP in Enugu State. I'm telling you the truth. That's the reality. Otherwise, can one person have structure in the state? The answer is no. The structure belongs to many people. So you can only be financier you can only be highest financier of the party. But that does not mean that you have to be a sole leader of the party. Are you getting my point?
Very well.
But that is what he is using to get money from his father. To get money from his father. Because if we are there about 3-4, and I don't know how can we handle the things without our former governor, Excellence Bingadale. How do we do it, OGG? I don't see it. How do we do it? How do we do it? If that can ask the God to push it to the man, that without the man that you can win in Enugu State, how is it going to be possible? Can I say without the man I can win in Enugu State? It's not possible. Because all these members that were even carried up and now, they were all belong to Bingadale before. What are we talking about? And the still majority of them, those who have power, who have money, who are real leaders in Enugu State, up to today, all of them are still loyal to our leader, Bingadale. So if Lavi believe that he can do anything without Bingadale, if me myself, Kashamu, the way I've seen, if I myself believe that I can do anything with Queen Adana, I will be deceiving myself and be deceiving the good people of the state.
Alright, sir. Thank you for the time. Talking about the crisis that we have mentioned on the time of the at the time by that, the shifting of the party, one said the problem of PDP in the country started in Ogun State. And that if the problem of PDP will ever end, they have to come back to the state. Also, you have mentioned some of the problems, some of the challenges to that is intervening against reconciliation. How possible is it that the PDP in the state will have all these matters settled permanently?
My brother, let me answer that, sir. One of the petitions in the
My brother, I've said in my message now that I've thrown the reconciliation to them. You understand? But if they are not willing, if it is business, by using that to get money from his father, you understand? The problem will continue. Me, I can only do what I can do to put other people together. Do you understand? Except at the end of the day, if the other members who are with him, your sons and saying, realize that he does not have nowhere to take them to, do you understand? If 90% to 95% of them, because at least 75% of them are my own people that went there, but many of them are coming back now. If I can be able to confuse maybe about almost 75 to 80% more, if they join us, do you understand? Then we will not need it. But as it stands now, I'm ready to sacrifice yourself, whatever it takes, in order for the party to be stable. Your sons are saying, to be stable in the state. That is why I propose that let us do reconciliation. Even if you like, you said that you want governor, it's okay. I give you, I don't have any problem. But you won't go over that does not mean that only you will be the candidate of if we want the PDP to win in Ogun State. Yes, all of us can support you, can be behind you. But likewise, other people can come and contest. But as for me, never. I will never contest for any position in Ogun State again. But there is no way you will be seeing yourself as Alpha Omega, the way Ladi is doing. And you think that the party will move forward. It's not possible. Because you, if you want to contest for governorship, you want to be a candidate tomorrow, the other want to be a candidate, as long as you know that Ladi is the sole, yourself, I'm saying, candidate in the PDP, will you come? You won't join them now. So how do you want the party to be settled? It's going to be difficult. And that is what the game that is playing now. He is thinking, he is Alpha Omega. He alone can win. You join APL, you do not win. How manage you can be thinking, imagine that yes, if only you, if you don't reconcile with Kashamu, you don't reconcile with OGD, you don't reconcile with Bakode, only you can win the election in Ogun State. He must be joking. He doesn't know what he's doing. So we have started. There's no any problem in Ogun State anymore. The only person that is causing the problem is Ladi Adebutu. And I urge the national for them to leave us because all politics are local. They should leave us for us to resolve our problem in the state. Fawzi should keep to his equity because he is facing his own problem over there with Ogunjimi. He should remove his fucking arm in Ogun State matter. You that you cannot even be able to resolve your problem in equity. How can you be putting your dirty mouth in Ogun State problem? That's number one. Number two, you found here that they took you as a leader of Southwest before. When you betrayed me, you cannot even have last election. You couldn't be able to do anything. You couldn't be able to perform. How can you be fighting again now that you want to become a leader in Southwest? What kind of leader? When we have respectable governor, Sheyi Makinde, we have him there. We have other leaders. We have Baba Bode George. We have our father, Baba Bode George, as a leader of Southwest. All the BB people that they support to put them together in order for us to restore their Southwest. You are not doing that. You are playing with, only you are playing with Secondus because of the position that Secondus is fighting for the second time. You are lying to Secondus, and they should not allow Uyinola to come in. Uyinola want to become chairman, and that is why Secondus, they started doing a lot of things in Southwest, changing many structure in Southwest. Where is he going to take us to? He can't take us to anywhere. Do you understand? So the problem now is not only the problem of Ogun State. It's the problem that's surrounding all the Southwest. How do we resolve this problem?
It's about, I think we have answered some part of the question that Ejinabada said, you don't want peace in PDP. Yes, and you have spoken about, you're a man of peace, you want peace in PDP. And that's why I said you have answered the question.
Thank you
very much.
So,
if you want to come
answer all of
them. If you want to come, 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 if you want to come.
Yes, I have one. Since you have decided for a reconciliation, sir.
If you don't leave them, I'll quit. Go to the other one, I will not do. Let them do their work. You work with them. That's all.
Yeah.
I'm not perfect. Anything that you know that is correct, you can have it by yourself.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying? So that's it.
Okay, sir. Since you have decided for a reconciliation, you have thrown a peace hand to them that, okay, if they want to reconcile, you are ready to reconcile. What will you be expecting from Ladi Adebutu now that, okay, if there is reconciliation, what will you be expecting? Are you going to give him, okay, if you want reconciliation, I will give you, you give me XYZ, or I will give you this ticket, I will give you this, but this is what I want from you from reconciliation. Is there anything like that?
To add to it, sir, let me be just a point of, are you suggesting that there should be a sharing of the ESCO?
Yes, my brother. When we are talking about, when you said that now that I've determined your son to go for reconciliation, that's not correct.
Mm-hmm.
Your son of saying, I have never denied or refused any reconciliation from the beginning. I've just said to you now that this is a business opportunity, your son, that comes out that Ladi believes in. Your son, this is what he is using now to suck money from his father. There is no way Ladi Adebutu will ever accept, your son, I'm saying, reconciliation is not possible. He can never, because I've already thrown it out. I've already thrown it out that if I'm able to, and I repeated the same thing now, that if he said that he's looking for governorship, let him have it. This is our last opportunity for them all. Let him have it. I'm ready. I don't have any problem. I have never against Ladi being a governor. I'm never against Ladi being a senator. Do you understand what I'm saying? It is not in my power. It is the power, it is in the power, in the hand of Almighty God. Even if I say, I want to do this now, I want to do that, who am I? Who am I? It is only God that decides. You see that all the challenges I've been facing in this country, you've witnessed a lot of things. Do I have power to face? Do I have power to exonerate myself with those mighty powers? But Almighty only that sees my heart. Whenever they bring the power, they bring the problem, he removes me from the problem. That alone speaks for himself. I do not have juju. I do not rely on anybody except only Almighty Allah. There is no problem that I've never seen since I entered these politics, but God will call and just take me out. That nothing will touch you, my son. I have never once enforced any reconciliation. But the truth of the matter, reconciliation is not possible with God the Almighty, because that is his own way of making money. That is his own way of making money. You will check if he lost election, I mean if he lost the judgment, the case, 2 days before election in 2019, then you move. You quickly go and join APM, collect, he collected 500 million from APM, sign an agreement to them. Does he want good thing for the PDP? Does he want? Am I not a member of PDP? But I've once supported your ticket to House of Rep. Do you understand what I'm saying? Even though if you lose the case, what does it take you in supporting me if it is true that you love the PDP, that you want the PDP to succeed? Why do you have to move as a prostitute? Go and sell yourself and remember your members to APM. Then when the APM lose now, the agreement still remains 2 years, you still come and be fighting that you are the leader. You want to take the social ability. Is that how to manage the party? Why can't you people see it from other side for you to know that this man doesn't want anything called reconciliation? You want to be Alpha Omega, you want to be general of the army, you want to be Obaleya, you want to be, I don't know, you understand? You want to be everything and become governor. How can Ladi have a god to go and fight with all people that train you? Now calling yourself overall leader